Hey guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to Equilinox. In the last episode, we gained access to the chickens of the world, and as you can see, we may have gone a little bit overboard. There are so many chickens pecking around these hills now, but at least we have plenty of wheat for them to keep themselves sustained. It doesn't look like they're running too low, but with the population density out of control like this, it does seem to be putting a little bit of strain on their lives. So hopefully they'll be able to even themselves out. That's kind of what happened to our sheep. Oh, and do we have some brand new little babies? Just as the elders pass away, that was a wonderful sight. Well, little Bo Peep here has some babies to take care of. Is your name... did I read that right? This sheep's name is Yogi Bear. Okay, Mr. Yogi. Maybe we were right to try to turn this place into a forest. That's kind of what's on the agenda today. We're still trying to work out how to evolve our birch trees, and I made a discovery while I was fiddling around with things off camera. So there's a little icon up here for the biome picker, and if we choose this, it'll give us some more information about the place that we're in. It'll show us what the biome is. So of course, if this is the grassland, it's not quite a forest just yet. We're going to have to try to figure out how to turn this place into a forest. Maybe we need more types of trees, or the mushrooms even. I don't think we've placed down the mushrooms yet, so maybe we'll have to try that out. But it also tells us the altitude of these hills, and that's where we were struggling when it came to evolving these birch trees. If I remember correctly, we had to set them up an altitude somewhere over 30 meters. 35 is the magic number, so this hill is clearly not high enough. So if we go back to the biome picker tool, it should be much, much easier for us to figure out where to place these birch trees. So as you can see, none of these hills are really going to be enough here. Even at the highest peak, it's not quite tall enough for us to evolve this tree. This entire stretch just seems to be too low, so let's head off in the other direction because these hills look much, much higher. Right over by our wheat fields, in fact. Oh yeah, look at this. If we place our birch trees up here, that should be just enough for us to finally start evolving them. So I guess that means we're going to have to spread our grasses over here as well, because the birch trees won't survive for very long if we put them in that barren land. It didn't even have a name to the biome, did it? Just a dry, inhabitable wasteland. So we'll start by spreading a little bit of grass up on top of the hills, and then we'll get to work. Oh, hello! Hello, little clouds! Guess this just goes to show how high up we really are up here. I wonder what other sorts of animals are going to enjoy a place like this. Now, while all of that grass is spreading around, why don't we go back to our little oak forest, and we'll start placing some mushrooms inside. I think there may have also been a task for the mushrooms, so let's see if we can figure that out too. The mushroom mastery task. Mushrooms are a wonderful addition to almost any habitat. Work your way through the mushroom evolution tree and unlock all the different mushroom species to complete this task. So that's the tall mushroom species, the jungle mushroom, the red mushroom, and the tropical mushroom. That is a lot of mushrooms, and it sounds like quite a few of them have to do with like jungle landscapes. So a bit of a diversion from the birch trees that we're looking at right now. But where do you think would be a good spot for us to set up a little jungle? I'd imagine quite far away from our grasslands, because I'm sure the two won't mix very well. I don't know, maybe that'll have to be next on our list. Well, for now, let's go ahead and just place a couple of these mushrooms down. We could use our button mushroom. These are pretty cute, and it looks like they are very, very happy with this landscape. We'll go ahead and place a couple right next to our trees, and hopefully they can help keep our biome nice and healthy. I remember from Taito Ecology that mushrooms were extremely important to our ecosystems. They helped clean up our biomes, and a few of them also made for some pretty tasty snacks. I'd imagine that they'll probably start spreading like wildfire after some time, but they are very, very healthy. And actually, their population density is a little bit low, so hopefully they're going to start spreading sooner rather than later. I don't want to waste too many points on the same old thing, so we'll just let Mother Nature take care of it. Now, how are our green rolling hills looking? Do you think this will be enough for some birch trees? It's looking mighty green. perhaps not as green as the grasslands, but I think it's going to be enough. So let's use our biome picker again to find the perfect place. I suppose right up on top of this hill should be good. So let's go ahead and grab our birch trees and plop a couple of these down. Now, next we're going to want to alter the color of these trees. We need to make them red in order to progress with the evolution. We only have about 7,000 points right now though, so hopefully that's going to be enough. I think we may have wasted quite a few points with all of those mushrooms. Yeah, we need about 9,000, almost 10,000 of these discovery points in order to change it. So I guess we still have a bit of work to do. Well, let's see if we can finish off any more tasks on our list while we're waiting for our points to fill up in our bank. We have the Under the Sea task, and I believe that has something to do with the seaweed that we unlocked the other day. Now that you have a seaweed species, you can start to spread wildlife under the water as well. Start a new underwater ecosystem by placing the seaweed in some sufficiently deep water and wait for it to spread, creating a new river biome. Alright, so we need 10 seaweed in the world, and just like with our grass, I would imagine a couple of them in the water should be enough to help it spread. So we won't waste too many of our points. Let's just place some right under the water next to the shore. And I guess this is going to be our very first river biome. So I wonder if it'll give us some fish to play around with? Maybe different species depending on what type of body of water this is. This will be a normal old river, but I wonder if we could set up a body of water to feel a little bit more like an ocean. A warmer climate, maybe some coral, and that would surely affect the species inside. Oh, that seaweed is spreading like wildfire now. It looks like we actually completed the task already. Yeah, I had a feeling that we didn't have to place too many of those down. Seaweed is basically just the grass tufts of the sea. So let's go ahead and claim that reward. Oh, and then we are so close to having enough to actually change those birch trees. And it looks like we may have unlocked the trout species. Excellent, so we can actually add some fish into our pond right here. Well, we might as well add one group of fish, if this is a suitable biome anyways. Maybe we should do a bit more research before we plop them in. What does it say about the trout? A small freshwater fish that lives in the rivers and lakes of Equilinox. It swims around aimlessly most of the time and is often hunted by larger fish. It needs to have some water plants in its habitat in order to survive. Oh, and just like all of the other animals, we can even change the colors around too, I'll bet. So we could have some super colorful fish. So its suitable biome is a riverbed, and I guess that's kind of what we're growing right now, but we wouldn't want to place it in any tropical locations. And just like our good old chickens, it is great at fleeing from predators. Let's take a look at its evolution tree as well, just to see what else we might be able to uncover in the future. A redfish, a pike, and a clownfish. Excellent, so we could make Nemo if we put together a little beach. Well, aside from the seaweed, I'm not sure what else we could put inside this river to make it more suitable. It is slowly becoming a riverbed biome, so maybe this will be enough? I guess we just have to have tons and tons of seaweed, right? And eventually this is going to continue spreading. So let's go ahead and try plopping this little guy inside. Oh, I am awfully worried about him though. Right about here seems to be the best location. I think. It is kind of going down again. Well, let's place our first trout in and see how he does. Oh, he's so tiny. Oh, you can barely see him at all. Well, you don't have to worry because nobody is going to be hunting you anytime soon. You are literally the only fish in this entire stream. He seems to be doing pretty well too. Oh, but they don't have names? No names for our fish. That's kind of sad. Though I guess it probably would get a little bit out of hand. So if we want to work on selective breeding with our trout, we can actually change its edibility. Make it a little bit tastier for the animals around the grasslands, I guess? Or maybe the other fish inside the stream? Interesting. I guess we'll have to keep that in mind. But we are so close to being able to unlock that special color. How's our birch tree doing up here? It looks like it is starting to get rather old, so we'll probably have to choose one of the newer ones. Oh, and I think because this one was born right on the edge of the grasslands. It's kind of struggling right now. So let's go ahead and help you along. We'll place some grass right in this middle stretch because it doesn't seem like anything is filling in between these two patches. Oh wow, our mushrooms are doing a great job spreading. Oh my gosh, I think there might be more mushrooms in here than even all of these little grass tufts. Yeah, now the population density is nice and high. Now, has that changed anything about this place? Nope, it is still mostly a grassland. Ah, but the area right next to the river is now considered a riverbed. So it's pushing beyond the stream too and eating into our grasslands a little bit. Well, I wonder how our little sheepy friends feel about that. I mean, they still have plenty of grasslands to roam around in. Yeah, seems like they're doing just fine. Oh, Yogi Bear, you're already nearly at the end of your lifespan? It just goes so quickly. Sometimes I feel like we don't have enough time to get attached to these little critters. I guess that's kind of the point, though. This is an ever-changing world, and it's slowly evolving into something unique every single day. Now we finally have enough to go alter our birch trees. So let's see if this one is doing okay now. Its health is a little bit better. And honestly, I think we're just gonna have to go with it because the other trees are too old. So if we head back into the traits panel, we should be able to alter the color of this one over to red. I'm not really sure what the slider does. Does that actually mix the colors? Oh, interesting. So we could get like an orangish yellow color instead, or all the way over to the right, which makes it a pure red. Well, for the sake of this task, we are going to change it over to red, but that's pretty cool. So I wonder if there could be like a wide selection of shades that it could use depending on how much of it is actually passed. Oh no, it looks like the trees might be getting a little bit too close to our chickens' territory. Something tells me they're not too happy about that. The chickens absolutely hate the trees. So I wonder if there's a way that we could move these out of their land. We can transplant them for a certain amount of these discovery points, or we could just remove them. I don't know. Maybe we should just send them packing. That way our chickens will be happy and they won't end up passing away due to stress. There we go. Prince is feeling much, much better now. Yeah, the chickens are pretty picky when it comes to trees. They just want these wide open fields full of wheat to roam around in. And their stones too. They do seem to favor this nice big chicken rock.
Ooh, do I actually see one of the tiny red trees? Oh, excellent, that means it worked. So, can we start evolving the tree with this little sapling?
Oh no, are you kidding me? It's not high enough?
Oh, that is so disappointing. It grew just a little bit too low. If only it was this one, I'm sure we would have no trouble.
Oh man, maybe we should have changed the color of this tree instead. But unfortunately, I think we still have to purchase it to use it again. That is such a bummer.
But at the very least, now that we actually have a red birch tree growing, that means it should spread even farther. So maybe this one will eventually crawl its way up the hill.
Actually, how high is this? Is it literally just 1 point away? 1 meter away from being high enough? Oh my gosh, you guys.
Oh, wait a second though. I see another one. Oh, please tell me you're high enough. You might be just a tiny bit higher than the other one. Yes. We can finally start breeding the red maple tree.
And since this one is just a tiny little sapling, I'd imagine that we should probably be able to finish it in its lifespan, so we won't have to worry about waiting around for another red birch tree to grow.
Oh, excellent, we are finally getting somewhere.
So if I remember correctly, the red maple tree was one part of 3 different trees that we need to evolve. We also need to grow the wobbly tree and the wild mint too. So the wobbly tree is another thing that we can evolve from the birch trees. That's the second one on their evolution list. But I think the wild mint was part of the grass tufts. There it is. So let's see what requirements we need to meet.
We actually need to increase the size of our grass tuft in order to change it to the wild mint. And we need to make sure that our grassland biome is very, very strong. So this would probably be the best place for us to take care of that. Let's see if it's strong enough here.
Yeah, so this is definitely a good old grasslands biome. That's what we've been working on with our little sheep.
So all we need to do is adjust the size of this thing. And it wasn't by very much. Maybe by just a few percent will do. And it looks like the highest we can go up to right now is 5%. So let's stick it at right about there. Ooh, and we've successfully evolved our red maple tree. All right, let's see if we can find it. Oh, is this our first red maple? Oh my gosh, it looks so cute. Oh, can we move it just like the wheat? It looks like we can. So I guess we might as well just leave it up here. I'm going to assume that if we had to keep the birch trees at such a high height, we probably want to do the same for our little red maple. Oh no, the environment is terrible. Where did we go wrong? Its preferred habitat is the grassland biome at medium to high altitudes. It enjoys living in rock-free areas. Well, I know for sure that this is definitely a rock-free area. Oh, wait a second. Maybe this is what's causing the trouble? Can we actually move the rock? Just get it out of the way? Yeah, let's just go ahead and remove it. We don't even have any wheat up here anyways, so we probably don't need it hanging around. Did that help you any? That was the entire issue. It just could not handle growing next to that giant boulder. Alrighty, little one. No more rocks for you. This is going to be a rock-free zone. We could probably spare a couple of mushrooms, though. The mushrooms seem to do such a good job over in our previous little forest. I'm sure it would help this place thrive as well. Honestly, this little hill is going to look pretty amazing once it's all fully grown. It'll be like a tiny slice of autumn overlooking our grassy fields. Oh my gosh, and I almost forgot about all of our fish. Look how they have multiplied. Oh, there are so many fish down here now. It looks like they're doing pretty well too. The only reason why their health is so low is because they are getting pretty old. But the population density is nice. Their environment is looking pretty excellent. I'd say we did a pretty good job in our very first aquatic ecosystem. Wait a second. What is this little thing over here? Is this a purple birch tree? Where on earth did this thing come from? Oh my gosh, we actually have a purple birch tree? Ooh, we are going to have to try to keep this thing alive then. Oh, could we have a little purple magical birch tree forest way up here on top of this hill? That would be so cool. A red birch forest on one side and a purple birch forest on the other. I have no idea where this thing came from though. Oh my gosh, and it's growing. Oh, it looks so gorgeous. We are going to have to make sure that this thing survives. And we'll have to see if maybe we can get some more animals in these places too. I wonder if any of our current animals would enjoy living in higher altitude. I would imagine that we'd probably be able to evolve some of our species as well. If I remember correctly, the sheep can actually evolve into the goats. And as I suspected, the altitude needs to be pretty high for that. They also need snow too, though. And I think I saw some snow covering the mountains at the highest peaks. I wonder if that would be a fun thing for us to explore. We could make a little group of mountain goats who can scale even the toughest of cliff sides. And given our current sheep's bouncy nature, I'd imagine that's going to come quite naturally. So in the next episode, we'll dive a little bit deeper into the evolution of our various species. Our plants, our animals, and our fish. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye guys!